Hello and welcome back to Red Stapler channel. In this episode, we're going to show you how to create realistic texture reflection effect like this, running on web browsers with 60 frames per second using Three.js and JavaScript in just a few minutes. Ready? Let's check it out. So here's the example page that we are going to work on. Just a few CSS background gradient setup, and that's it. Next, we are going to prepare Three.js library. You can download the latest release from GitHub if you are not using npm or any package management. So first, we will need a core library folder. I will copy the entire build folder and place it into our project. Next, we'll need three additional add-on files for this project. The first one is orbitcontrol.js inside example/jsm/controls. This file will be used for camera mouse control. Second is rgbeloader.js located inside jsm/loader. We'll use this file for texture loading. And the last one is flakes.texture.js located inside jsm/texture. We'll use it to generate the texture. I will create a JS folder in the project and put these files into it. Now, let's start working on the code. First, I will create a script tag inside the body and import all the library files. And then I will set up global variables like scene, camera, renderer, mouse controls, and light. Then create an initialize function. First, we will set up the scene and WebGL renderer. I will set the alpha to true to make the scene background transparent so we can see the CSS background. Then also set the anti-alias to true. Then set the size to the current browser viewport and add it to the body as canvas element. For the camera, I will use the perspective with 50 FOV, using current window aspect ratio and 1000 viewing frustum. I will place the camera 500 units away from the center and initialize the mouse control using orbit control. For the light setup, I will use a simple white color point light with 1 intensity. I will place it 200 units away and add it to the scene. Now for the sphere, I will use sphere geometry with 100 unit size and 64 width and height segments. For the material, I will use mesh physical material which support advanced reflection rendering, but for now we will leave the parameter as empty. Then create a 3D object and add it to the scene. Inside the loop function, we'll update the mouse control, call the render method, and make the recursive call using request animation frame, and call the in function to start the scene. Now, if everything is correct, you should see a white sphere at the center of the screen. Next, let's work on the texture. I will create a canvas texture and pass the new flakes texture as model. Then set both vertical and horizontal texture wrapping as repeat wrapping. Then set horizontal texture repeating to 10 times and vertical to 6 times. Next, we'll work on setting up the physical material. It's easier to understand each setting by try experimenting with the demo on the Three.js documentation page. But for now, I'm going to set the clear code to 1. And clear code roughness to 0.1. Metalness to 0.9 and roughness to 0.5. Set the color to purple, and then add our texture as normal map. And set the normal scale to 0.15. Then add setting to the material constructor. Okay, let's see the result. This looks pretty ugly, but the next step is going to change it. First, I will change the texture encoding. There are several encoding available in 3.js, but for this tutorial, I'm going to use sRGB encoding. You can try experimenting the rest by yourself. Next, I will change the tone mapping to Aces Filmic and increase the exposure by 25%. Looks good. Next, we'll work on the reflection. We will need an environment map to create reflection on the sphere. So I'm going to download a free HDR file from Polyhaven and put it in our project. Then to load the texture, I'm going to use RGBE loader and set the path to our HDR file. And then in the callback function, we'll move the sphere creation code inside. Then we'll use PM Rem Generator, which is Pre-Filter Mipmap Radiance Environment Map Generator, to generate the map from our HDR file. So, create the PM Rem Loader object from our renderer. Then use FromCubeMap method and pass our HDR file into it. Then set the environment map parameter for our physical material. And that's it. And as a final touch, I will add an auto rotation and enable damping to smooth out the mouse control. So that's all for this tutorial, hope you guys enjoy. If you like this video and want to see more web development tips and tutorials, subscribe our channel to stay tuned. Thanks for watching, see you next episode. Bye!